Greetings, everyone. This is Queen Ifama. I am the Truth Terrorist. Welcome. I'm doing this video as a request. And the request is, and I'm hopefully I got it right, is why I call myself black and not brown. Okay. And, you know, I started to go all into this historical shit. You know what I'm saying? But really, that's not why I do it. Okay, because I say I identify as black because, you know, and it's not racial. Well, I guess you could call it race. But anyway, race is not a fact of biology, but it's a construct that varies across everybody's culture. But anyway, I'm going to tell you why I identify myself as black. Second. Because first of all, I identify myself as woman in the first place, you know, primarily. But I identify myself as black, and that has a lot to do with my history, my personal history. And I came up during a time, you know, particularly in my early years. And when I say early years, I mean like from zero all the way up to about maybe, I'd say 16, perhaps, where if you call somebody black, you get your ass whooped. People just didn't take being called black because it was a negative, you know, because everything that's associated with black, and we can testify to that, is negative in a way, you know, except for devil's, well, that's a devil. So we ain't talking, even though devil food cake is dark, it's a dark cake, okay? So everything that's associated with darkness or blackness has been associated with something negative or evil or, you know, dirty or something like that. So to be classified, to have someone call you black, it would bring up those images of something that's, you know, not pure, not good, something that's dirty. It would be brought up like that. And even, you know, back then, black people was referred to as black people. We were called black people. Now, like I said before, at another time, there are, you know, people who would say that, you know, the Kemetans, they were referred to as, that their land was referred to, Kemet, as the land of the blacks. I've heard that that's not true, that it was referred to as the black land. So, you know, where we started, we calling each other black and white, you know, and I think white is the more recent word than black. I think black people have been called black for a very long time because there are indeed black people. I'm talking about people that's Crayola black, particularly when you go into Sudan and all those places like that. You find black people that are very, very, very dark. I mean, darker than I am. You know, what they call blue black. What they used to call my uncle. They used to call my uncle blue black. Because he was really, really dark, right? And so, primarily, for me, well, never for me, but for other people, they would always, you know, try to get back at somebody by calling them black. You know, and black would always be the descriptor, like, you know, like the dude, the woman Muna called me a black bitch, or someone to say, get your black ass in here, or, you know, shut your black ass up, or some shit like this. They would use that as part of the negative derogatory statement. It would always be in a negative sense. You know what I'm saying? They don't be like, bring your pretty black ass over here. That was rare, okay? When I was coming up, all right? Just like your nappy hair was rare. You know, everybody pressed their hair because they, you know, because a nappy head was a social negative, okay? So, like, when the 60s came around and people were fighting for their civil rights and black power and, you know, things like that, and natural hair became more acceptable, and then we start recognizing our skin color. Skin color, as dark people, we became more accepted, or whether maybe not so much accepted, but we began to accept ourselves as darker skinned people. and we accepted the terminology of black for the whole race. Now, we didn't get off into, you know, if you're yellow skin, if your skin is yellow or kind of orangey or brown or, you know, pear color or, you know, some stuff like that. Black was applied to the whole group of us, regardless of the shade of our skin. You know, because we vary in our skin tones as quote unquote black people. And also, you know, I found it easier for me to identify with another person that looks like me and just saying I'm black, they're black. It's easy. But, you know, they brought in so many confusers, like, you know, African American. Then you got, yeah, I mean, it's just so many. I just choose to keep it simple. And I just choose to accept the fact that I'm black. And I'm the, and see, it's not negative for me. And that's where I find people have the most problems, is because it brings up images of negativity. But for me, it doesn't bring up images of negativity. It brings up a collective image of a group of people who are called black. Just like we look at a group of people and call them white, even though we did not call ourselves black. The white people called themselves white, you know, at a particular time in history. They all identified as white. But for us, we've always been called black. And that's probably because there are some black people. And we're just all lumped in that group of black people. So I accept the term black because it's just simpler. And I don't have a problem, and I don't take it as a negative. You know, I take it as a collective term that's used for a group of people who are of African descent. You know, whether they're light skin, dark skin, brown skin, you know, yellow skin, it really doesn't matter. For me, they're all black. Now, do we all relate to each other as black people? No, but we, you know, in a way we kind of do. We know that that's another black person, you know, but I wouldn't look at somebody and say, oh, you're an African American, because you may not identify yourself as, you may not even be from America, but you're black. You see what I'm saying? So I can kind of, you know, take that, because it's simpler. It's just easier for me. I don't like to get all bogged down in confusing and trying to make people you know, identify themselves as something else, and then you got this other group of people that's something else, and then you have this other group of people that's something else. I identify everybody of African descent as black in America, okay? Like, some people want to identify with enslaved Africans. Look, before we were enslaved as Africans, we were referred to as black. Like I said, there was a time when that wasn't even negative. It just became negative. And so everybody took offense in the earlier, you know, years of being called that. But I don't have a problem with being called black. As a matter of fact, James Brown came out with a song, "Say It Loud, I'm Black and I'm Proud." And there's plenty of poetry and all types of things that attest to the beautifulness of being black. And so I use the term widely, proudly, and I don't mind anyone calling me black at all. Even if they use it as a descriptor before they curse my ass out, you know, because they think that's probably an insult. And like I said, it's not an insult. I'm proud to be black, dark skin. Now, like I said, some people, you call you black because you're dark skin. I mean, like a darker skin. When I say black, I'm talking about black people as a whole. You know, we're all black. But in particular, I make a note when people really use it for people that's dark skin. And this is generally people that are lighter skin. But for me, everybody's black that's of African descent here in America, on the continent, wherever they are, they're black to me. You know, and I also say, you know, you could be African if you want to. But all black people are not going to identify themselves as African. They'll say they're African descent, but they're not going to say they're African if they have not never put their foot on the shores of Africa, of the continent of Africa. So they're not going to identify and say that they are Africans. I identify myself as black. I identify myself as a woman, and I identify myself as an African. So I could say that I'm a black African woman. I put it all in one little thing. A black African woman. Okay? Or a woman of African descent that's black. Either way you go. You know? So for me, I keep it simple. I don't try to get all bogged down and distance somebody because they don't want to call themselves black. You know, to me, in my mind's eye, you are black. Okay? And if you don't want me to call you that, I won't call you that. But in my mind's eye, you're still black to me. So that's why I don't mind being called black. Okay? Not at all. You know? And it doesn't bother me that people refer to me as black because it's not negative. So I hope that that answered your query about my thoughts on why I say I'm black and not brown. Because I do know that brown is, that's what color my skin is. If you know, it's a shade of brown. You know, it's kind of like brown chocolate with a little black in it. You know? It's so, you know, but still, as a collective, I accept black. It's just simpler for me. You know, I ain't gonna just go over to the whole group of people that's the same shade. I'm gonna go run around matching shades with people. Oh yeah, you brown like me. No, you this color brown. No, you that color brown. No, you this color light yellow. No, you this color, you beige. No, you really vanilla color. No, and that's a waste of time. I don't have time for that. That's ridiculous. I identify with other people that's black. Whether they identify themselves as black or not, it really makes me no difference. I still identify you as black as opposed to your ass being white. Now, if you white and you look white, see, if to me, if you look white, you're white. Unless you say, oh, no, I'm not white. I'm actually black. I'm actually of African descent. Then I say that's a black person, just light skin. Okay, so that's just how I do it. I mean, like I said, I keep it simple. A lot of you want to get all complicated and technical and, you know, all that other kind of stuff and got to bring up archaeology and what they call what African people of African descent or Kemetan descent or Egyptian descent called themselves thousands of years ago. I could give less than two shits about that. That's the past. I'm talking about right now and what I identify with mine eyes. What I see and who I identify with. It's also a psychology. It's a mentality as far as I'm concerned, you know? So if people identify themselves as black, I think they would treat other people that's black good as well. You know what I'm saying? My thing is to treat everybody right, like you want to be treated, regardless of their skin color. But as I said, because race, which is a construct built on black, white, yellow, red, you know, those colors, then we have all these differentiations in how we treat each other and where the power is and where the economy is and who runs it and all that other kind of stuff. But at the end of the day, I'm a black woman. Period. And that's what I identify as, you know. So I hope that, you know, settled that for you as far as my opinion of it is concerned. What anyone else wishes to call themselves is up to them. I will, honor that. And upon addressing them directly, I will call them what they wish to be called. But, you know, as far as my mind's eye, I see everybody of African descent as black. So, you know, I just keep it simple. So anyway, I'm kind of tired, y'all. So I just did this video because I didn't want the person who questioned this, who asked about the black equal brown, you know, and why I would do that. I just wanted to get this out of the way so that it wouldn't be, you know, a long time. It's already been a few days, so I didn't want them to wait a longer time. And I wanted them to have my explanation as to why I, you know, call myself black. I don't have a problem with calling myself black. It's not negative. And even when I was coming up, I've never had a problem with people calling me black and trying to make me mad. It never did. Because I've always considered black to be beautiful even before they came out with the phrase, black is beautiful. I always thought, as a matter of fact, I didn't think about it at all. As a matter of fact, when I was younger, I never thought about it. You know what I'm saying? I never thought about, you know, light skin, dark. The only thing I would think about is why I didn't see, you know, black people on television. Because when I was younger, I didn't see black people on television a lot, you know. I think the first time I saw him was on the Ed Sullivan Show, I think. And I was really excited to see a black person on Ed Sullivan Show. You know, I think it was Ed Sullivan. I'm not sure. But all I know is it was never talked about negatively in my household. As a matter of fact, race was something that was not discussed in my household when I was coming up. So I didn't really learn about race until I ran away from home. And then I was about 14 and a half, almost 15 years old. And then I was introduced to, you know, racial conflict. I had never been called a nigga by anybody, even on my block. I never heard it until I came, you know, left home. So for me, it's always never been a problem. So with that said, this is Queen Ifama. I am the truth terrorist. Peace, everybody.